This is a wafer of Intel's 11th gen core processors, and each CPU here packs a ton of new technology that further pushes the boundaries of performance. Now let's take a moment here to talk just about a few of the reasons why 11th gen core, codenamed Tiger Lake, is so great. Now, one measure of a processor's performance characteristics is frequency, which is measured in clock cycles per second, also known as hertz. A hertz, or clock cycle, is a single electrical pulse of the processor. Think of it like turning a light switch on and off, where it performs some kind of action or calculation. Now these days, chips are running in gigahertz, which is in the billions of cycles per second. So, a CPU that can run at 1 gigahertz can perform a billion actions or calculations per second. Frequency has a profound effect on a processor's performance. Another measure of performance is how much work a processor can do for each clock cycle, which is referred to as instructions per cycle, or IPC. Now imagine if you had a pile of bricks at the front of your house that you wanted to move to the backyard for a gardening project. You could just move one brick at a time by yourself, but you'd probably soon look for ways to increase your IPC by recruiting friends and family to help, or getting the right tools such as a wheelbarrow, and making a path clear and wide enough for that wheelbarrow. Now these are all analogies for improving IPC. They all increase the number of bricks you can move at a given moment. Now, if you take all of that and move everyone faster, that's like increasing the frequency. When designing a processor, chip engineers take into consideration a lot of the same things. How to get the most amount of work done as efficiently as possible. Tiger Lake's microarchitecture is called Willow Cove, which further improves upon the efficiency of the previous microarchitecture, Sunny Cove, from the 10th gen Intel Core Ice Lake processors. But frequency and efficiency are the big drivers behind 11th gen Core's huge performance leap, a leap so big that it's the largest performance gain yet within a process technology in Intel's history. Intel engineers have refined the process technology called SuperFin with new high-performance transistors that are able to switch faster and an improved metal stack that delivers solid current faster, making the entire CPU more responsive. SuperFin enables Tiger Lake to crank the frequencies up nearly a gigahertz. Again, that's close to a billion cycles per second over last year's model. That's huge. Now remember, higher frequency means that it can get more work done faster, and achieving higher frequencies is a key aspect of performance in general computing, which includes most of what people do on a regular basis. From gaming to productivity to really common tasks like web browsing. Now there's also a hidden benefit to the improved frequency range in Tiger Lake. While it can run at significantly higher speeds than the previous generation, it can also run at much lower voltages at a given frequency. For those moments between bursts of performance, such as loading a web page, it can mean less heat and energy consumption. Here's an actual example of Sunny Cove and Willow Cove running WebExpert 3 side by side, simulating a web browsing workload using HTML5 and JavaScript. On the bottom part of the screen, you can see the real-time frequencies between these two compared, with Willow Cove on the right side, that's the microarchitecture in 11th gen core, achieving higher frequencies, and thus better performance, at the same voltage. It's a win-win situation. Ultimately, a good design achieves a strong balance of multiple technologies together. Different parts of the processor have to work together and talk to each other, and it takes thoughtful engineering to eliminate any bottlenecks. This is especially important because 11th gen core has an amazing new integrated graphics engine, Intel Iris Xe Graphics, based on the XELP graphics architecture. And it is such a step up that we'll have to dedicate another video to that alone. But in a nutshell, Iris Xe integrated graphics in 11th gen core are dramatically faster and more capable than 10th gen core. It truly redefines a level of graphics you can get from a thin and light laptop. Now, to take advantage of the greatly improved graphics and CPU, Intel engineers have to come up with a better way to keep the processor constantly fed with all the data that it can crunch. Tiger Lake uses a ring design to connect various components to the chip. Going back to our early example, think of a ring design like that circular path that connects your front and back yards. You could move the bricks of the house, but you'd have to carefully navigate your way through. A better way in this specific design would be to go around the path outside. And that path is even wider on 11th gen core. Tiger Lake doubles the ring bandwidth over the previous generation by using a dual ring architecture. Tiger Lake also has a 50% larger last level cache over Ice Lake, which means it can keep more working data on the chip without having to fetch it from the outside memory or storage. In our gardening analogy, this is like being able to keep a larger set of tools out at the same time, instead of having a smaller set that you have to keep going back to the tool shed to swap out, or, even worse, making a dedicated trip to the hardware store. On top of all that, Tiger Lake has dedicated accelerators for artificial intelligence applications, like removing the distracting background noises that might be happening around you when you're on a video conference. AI on 11th gen is another topic so big that we'll have to unpack it in another video. But the main takeaway here is that Tiger Lake packs a ton of new innovations on the chip level, carefully balanced between each new feature with I/O, imaging, power management, display, that all have a meaningful real-world impact on what's possible on a laptop. Systems with 11th gen Intel Core and Iris Xe graphics will be available starting this fall 2020. Thanks for watching. I'm Marcus Yam. I'll see you in the next one.